In this tutorial, we will be seeing an interesting topic of playing a video on background. And so what we are trying to look in this particular tutorial, have a look before proceeding. So here you can see, this is a login screen which we are trying to design, and on the background you can see a video is being played. So isn't it interesting? So let's start building it. We will be displaying a login screen for the user. So sometimes we need to have these kinds of screens according to your application requirement, where you want to customize your application in a much easier way for the user to understand. For example, you want to let the user know what your application is about and you want to guide him through a video. So this tutorial will help you to make the things possible in your application here. So as part of tutorial, I have provided some sample video, but in your real-time implementations you can choose your video and can play it on the background of the screen like I have shown in this tutorial. So now let us start this tutorial and see what the things we have done in this particular tutorial and how we have achieved those things. So before getting further, so if you like these tutorials, subscribe to our channel and share it with your friends so that they might also get benefited with these tutorials. So here we are considering a video player dependency here. So why we are using dependencies and libraries? Because to make our work much easier and flexible here. Why? Because these are the tested libraries and we need not implement them again and again. We can just make use of them and we can make our functionality work. So in coming tutorials we will even see how to make these libraries. So here we are considering a video player library. Here we have added, and it's the current version is 1.0.1, and you can change it according to the latest version available at that particular time when you are implementing this tutorial so as to avoid any issues. We are not considering any local image as of now, but we are just trying to play a video from the URL. So here under the assets we have not provided any video here, as you can see now. So let us dive into the tutorial now. So here, as we have discussed in our previous tutorials also regarding the Flutter app implementations, like what is the structure of the programming. So again, I want to explain you, because there might be some new beginners who are seeing this video in our channel for the first time. So for them to make it familiar and easier, I'm just starting from the line one again. So if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. So here we are considering the default class MyApp here, and we are initializing with void main and we are extending it with the stateful widget here. So why stateful widget and why stateless widget? So if you are still having any questions regarding this, I have covered in my previous tutorials. And if you are a beginner, so please do watch them or let me know in the comment section below. I will help you to understand them. So here we are creating a state for MyApp class here, and using which we have initialized here a video player controller. We have added a dependency, right? So using which we have added this video player controller by importing the video player here. So here we have initializing our controller here. So regarding the controller also, I have provided a tutorial what is a controller and why we are using a controller here. Using a text field controller, I have explained, you may visit, I will be providing that link in the description section below. So here we are providing a sample MP4 video here. So you might provide any other link of your requirement here. So as this is a tutorial, I am providing a sample video. These sample videos are available for free to use. These sample videos are available, so I am using them in our tutorial now. And we are initializing our controller here. And here, coming to the design aspects here, we are returning a material app here. So this material app is having some inbuilt features which are helpful for our application designing. So we are returning a material app and inside which we are providing a scaffold here. So as we have discussed, scaffold provides the skeleton structure of our application. Inside the scaffold, we can provide app bar, body, and floating action buttons. And what are all the things we are having in the scaffold? You can just tap on the scaffold, and here these are all the things like app bar, body, floating action button, menu drawers, and all these kinds of things you can provide. Almost we have covered these topics like bottom navigation bar, bottom sheet, everything we have covered in our channel, and you can go and visit those things in our channel. So I just don't want to specify them now because we want to stick to this particular tutorial. Now we are declaring a stack here inside which we have declared a sized box here. So why? Because we want to have a login screen here, and we want to also provide a video on the background. So the constraints need to be fixed here. So here we are providing the constraints according to our screen size. So according to the screen size, our video will be exactly covers the entire screen, and in the center of the screen we are trying to display a login widget here. So here is a login widget, but before getting to the login widget, let us see what are all the things we are doing here. We have initialized the controller right in the above for the video controller. So we have provided it over here, and using which we will be trying to play the video. So here at the initialization level, we are trying to play the video. Here you can see we are not providing any button or any other method to start the video, but at the initialization itself. So as the screen is loaded itself, then we will be trying to play the video here, and we are making it in the looping here. So once the video is completed, then automatically it will restart here. So these two controllers, you may use it according to your requirement. In the child, we have declared a video player, and width and height also we have provided accordingly, and you can change them to your requirements. So if you want to provide the video in a particular part of your screen, then you can make it accordingly. So here, this is a sample login widget we have provided here. So what it contains is like a username and password here, text fields, and again two buttons like sign in and sign up, and these are all the general things we provide in our login screen, right? But in this particular tutorial, we are not going deeper into the login scenario, but just we are trying to show the screen design over a video here. So now let us try to look at the output. Here you can see this is the screen which we are discussing. So here the video you can see is playing on the background, and here inside a box we have provided a username, password, and two buttons here. So this is how you can make a screen in which a video is playing in the background. In the foreground, you are trying to display some elements over the screen. It might not be a login, or also you can create an intro screen for your applications. So you can check out the intro screen provided in the description section below, and you can add those intro screens also over the video screen. It will be much attractive for your user. In the first installation, he can get much deeper knowledge according to your application, what your application will do and what it will, how it will serve its purpose. And again, here is a debug banner. Here we have, as the application is not yet released, once you try to release the application, the debug banner will be automatically removed, and also you can also remove the banner by making it as a false in your scaffold here. And these are the things I want to provide you in this particular tutorial. And yes, also we have provided a video link here, right? So if you thought of providing your own video inside your application, so yes, that's also possible. Tap on the video player controller here, and here you can see the network we have considered now, and here below it there is also an option for playing the video from your file here. And also one more point I want to add here is, like, as we know that Flutter is an open source, so whenever you are having any query, So you can just tap on that particular widget here. So Flutter is a set of widgets. Everything is a widget here. Material app, scaffold, and what are all the things you are considered inside. So for example, you are having a query. So like what a scaffold can do, what a material app can do, what are the parameters available in this particular method. So if you are having any kinds of doubts, you can just tap on that particular widget, and here you can see what are all the methods available here and what are all the things you can perform. Here you can see for everything you can just tap on it and you can get the detailed knowledge on what is what here. So what a text field can do and what are the parameters and how can we adjust them according to our requirements. So yes, this is it for this tutorial, and if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.